So guys, in this video, we will learn about some basic queries of, this SQL. So we already learned about queries, right? Database queries. Queries means if you want to fetch some details from a database when there is a large amount of data available in that particular table. So here there is not a large amount of data, but still we will use some queries. So we are using this sentence, select star from student. This is also a query. Here this star, or you can say asterisk, it means that we will select all the columns from this student. Okay, you can obviously take a particular column as well. So if you want to take this student ID column only, then you can just write select then student ID from the table, that is student. Okay, now put semicolon and it will just fetch only the student ID column. You can write like this as well. So assume over here you can press enter. Okay, one second. Select ID, then in the next line you can just write from student. Some may write like this, so from student and then semicolon, and that also means the same thing, because this all things means a one statement. So it is also means a one statement. I already told you, if you don't use this semicolon, that will be considered as a one statement. Semicolon means at the end of the statement. So yeah, it will also fetch the same things. Similarly, you can take multiple columns as well. So select student ID comma and then name from the table, that is student. Fine, it will fetch only these two columns, and if you write select star, that will fetch all the columns. And you can put also conditions. Okay, so for example, if you just write select student ID from student table, where the class, actually let me see, where the class is this 12. Okay, where this class is equals to 12, right? Now put semicolon. It will put only one, because you can see from this original table only this first row has this class 12, so it is printing the student ID 1. Okay, you can put conditions as well. Similarly, you can put order by. Order by means you can put ascending order or descending order. For example, there is like 1 to 4, so we will just write select student ID then from student, okay, and order by name, order by student ID. Yeah, now put semicolon, and yeah, it will order by in ascending order. Similarly, you can write in descending order. So to write in a descending order, you just need to write select student ID then from student, and order by where is that, order by student ID, then you have to write DESC. DESC mean descending order, and put semicolon. Now you can see it is now in opposite 1 to 4 over here, and it is 4 to 1 now. You can use separate columns as well. You don't need to write student ID over here. You can write a name, class as well. So yeah, and you can also write these columns as the table dot then column name. In that case, it will be really helpful to understand you, like in future you can understand that this particular column is from that particular table. For example, I'll just show you. Select student dot name. So here the column name is name, but we are writing student dot name, that means table dot then column name comma student dot class. Okay, and then we have to write from student table. Okay, and suppose we will just write where student ID is less than 3. So that means this 1 and 2 will be printed. So in the original table, it will be printed this one first row and the second row, 1 Doraemon and 12, then 2 Doraemon and 8. Okay, so yeah, then put semicolon and it will run, and it will print only this first and second row, and it will print only the name and class. So you can write like this as well, student dot name and student dot class. Now assume if you wanna face some like some limited rows from a column. So let me just write over here select asterisk from student. Yeah, there are like 3 rows, right? suppose we want to fetch only two rows. In that case, we can set a particular limit. So we will just write select asterisk from student, and then we can set the limit. So it is limit equals to 2. So we don't need to write equals to, it's limit 2, and then put semicolon. It will now fetch only two rows. Okay, yeah, you can see. And you can also set order by with this. You can also set where conditions and all. So for example, I'll just write over here order by student ID, and it is, so it should be in descending order. So we'll just write over DESC, and then limit is 2. So that's fine. Let me just check it. Yeah, it's fine. Now if you just run this command, now you can see it is now totally opposite of that particular total set. So first of all, it's just ordered by the student ID. That means this 4 will be in the first row, and then 2 will be the second row. Then it set the limit and it printed only the first two rows. Now it is 4 and 2. Okay, now the last one is like not this kind of format. We will use this not equals to. We are using this less than equals to, greater than equals to sign, then and, or, but we are not using this not equals to, right? So for example, we will just add one more row in this table. So we'll just write insert into then the table name. So it is student, and then values. And the values will be assume now it is 5 comma, then the name is Alex, and the class is assume 5, yeah, and put semicolon, great. Now if you just fetch all the data from this table, you can see now there is one more row, that is 5, Alex and 5. Okay, so we will just fetch the data where the name is not equals to Alex. That means it should print only the first three rows. So in that case, you will just need to write select star from student where name, then the not equals to sign in SQL is less than and greater than symbol. That means the name is less than that particular name or greater than that particular name. That means that should not be equals to that particular name, right? So name not equals to, then we have to write the name, that is Alex, great, and you have to put semicolon after that. Now run this comment, you can see it is printing only the first three rows, it is not showing the last row. Okay, so this is the not equals to symbol in SQL.